Okay. Yeah, good morning all. So today in this particular session, we will try to complete your second part or second half of your unit 2. That is nothing but IoT system management using NetComm and YAN. So since we already discussed in the previous session, the introduction related to your IoT system management, like what are the basic requirements? Why we require this particular management of IoT systems? Since, okay, so we have seen several different type of requirements. What is the need we do have? So in that we have seen the different steps. And then followed with that, we discussed about something called as SNMP protocol. That is nothing but simple network management protocol, right? So basically we are discussing about management of IoT devices. So definitely we need to discuss about the protocols that are with respect to managing those IoT devices. So here in SNMP, we discuss what exactly it is, how it exactly communicates with other devices, make sure. And also we have seen some limitations. What are the basic limitations we do have with SNMP? Since it is a simple network protocol and nowadays we are getting very complex devices, it becomes very typical to use the same protocol for these particular complex devices. So that's the reason we have to come across with a new kind of devices or new kind of management protocol so that that can be used for accessing purpose and also for communication purpose. And in order to overcome that, that only we are going to discuss today. That is nothing but we call it as NetComm. So today we are going to cover this NetComm and YAN. Remember, NetComm is nothing but it's the protocol. What protocol? The first three letters refers network. The next three refers configuration. Now, this is configuration. Whereas coming to YAN, well, YAN is not a protocol here, but basically it is a module. YAN is a module. Okay, and this particular module we generally call it as data modeling language. It is a type of data modeling language which is used to specify the different type of representations related to your configurations, related to your operational related states. All that will be represented. Means it indirectly what it means to say is this is a kind of a programming a language using which we people will be programming the programs which will be used by this particular protocol, NetComm protocol. And that will be like something in NetBeans. Let us suppose, I think you people might be familiar with NetBeans and Eclipse. So whenever you people write some projects, what are you doing? You people will be displaying that particular in a systematic way, right? So you'll be arranging in a systematic way. You may be creating a lot of HTML pages. You may be providing a lot of connections to the database. All this you are representing in a systematic way. Same way here, that NetBeans, whatever we are using, same way here we are using your YAN module. Okay, using this module, we will be constructing different modules, and that module consists of the programs which need to be executed. Now, those programs are used by this particular protocol. Well, let me provide the introduction to NetComm, then we can go to that. But before that, we need to discuss about something called as what are the different requirements we do have for the network operator. So basically, this is a content related to that. In the previous session, we discussed about something called need for IoT management system. Then we discussed about SNMP. So today we'll try to cover these particular topics. So without wasting time, let's go into dive into it. So what do you mean by NetComm introduction? So basically here, coming to the NetComm here. So as I told you before here, NetComm is nothing but it's a combination of two different words. So net represents network and conf represents here configuration. Okay. Here, if you look about in this particular session, here it is a, what do you think exactly here is, it is a session-based network management protocol. Basically, it is a management protocol and what it is going to manage is nothing but your network. So within the network where we are communicating it, right? In between a source and destination, there exists some network through which we are able to transmit our messages. So that network, how to manage, we are using this particular protocol called as NetComm. Okay, so what for it is used? It is used for two different purposes here, mostly something called as state information and configuration data. So we can retrieve state and conf. So both are entirely different, remember that. State information is nothing but what state right now that particular device is present. Like whether it is trying to gather the information from the environment or it is trying to perform some kind of action, that it will consist of state. Okay, state data is actually classified into two types here, something called as operational data. It is something like operational data and another one is statistical. So basically, we have two different type of state information: operational data, statistical data. So what do you mean by operational data here? So whichever sensors we have deployed in the environment, this particular sensor is reading some kind of information. They are meant for some specific purpose. What is the purpose we do have here? For let us suppose this is a DHT sensor. DHT sensor is meant for what? For reading temperature and humidity. So whatever the readings this particular device or this particular sensor is performing, that is what we call it as operational data. Then what about statistical data? Well, this is not related to this. This is related to the whole system that has been deployed. Means statistical data will provide information related to the performance of a system. Like what, for example, this environment consists of three different type of devices. These are connected using NETCOM or SNMP. Now here, if any of the device is not functioning properly, let us suppose this device is not functioning properly, then that information is provided to the network operator, isn't it? Now how that is coming? You based on statistical information. It consists of the entire information related to the devices that have been connected together in the environment. Okay, and based upon the statistics, we people can provide information which one is functioning, how much amount of memory amount of energy is getting consumed one particular sensor, how much energy is left. Based on that, we can try to replace. Like we came to know that this particular device is not functioning. Immediately, one of the operator will go there, he will replace this particular device with a new one. So that information is provided with statistical data. Remember, there are two stages we have: state operational data and statistical data. What about configuration data? So name itself, it specifies configuration. So whenever a new version software comes up, we need to update these particular sensors, whatever the sensors we are using here. So these sensors need to be updated, isn't it? So that updation is done by this particular configuration data. So here, this particular protocol supports both the things: state data as well as configuration data. State data consists of operational data and statistical. Statistical data provides the performance of the system, whereas operational data is nothing but for what operation this particular sensors or the devices are performing, that data is gathered in operational data. I hope it is very clear. Yeah, let's go to the next one. Now this is the basic model or the basic protocol layers, what we have for this particular protocol. This network configuration management protocol basically has some layers. We have four layers here. Okay, so first we have something called as client, and then we have called as server. If you talk about, so what are the conversation that takes place between them and the client and the server, that will be based upon these particular modules. Yeah, these layers, sorry, not module, these are layers. And these layers are defined by whom? You please note this, Yang. Okay, Yang is very much important, because if you are using network configuration protocol, definitely Yang will come into picture, because he is the background worker. Okay, he is the background works are performed by this particular Yang. Now here we have layer something called as content, operational, RPC or notification. Now well, sometimes I might be using interchangeably the term. For the server, we can also call it as device. These are nothing but something like your IoT device, you can think, assume, not exactly IoT device, but some kind of device. Okay, it may be a data storing device or something like that. So server can sometimes interchangeably called as device. Whereas coming to client, for client also we do have other name. So what is the name we can provide here is nothing but, this is something called as management system. This is something we will be calling it as management system. Remember that. Don't forget that. Okay, so client sometimes can be called as management system, while server can be sometimes called as devices. Now, in this particular scenario, so let's begin discussion about these layers one by one from bottom to up top. The first layer, what we are going to discuss here is the transport layer. Okay, so basically, transport layer is the one which is used for transmitting the packets. We know that from client to server. So basically, what kind of protocol this particular transport layer will be using is SSH. Okay, so what is the full form for this SSH is nothing but it is a secure shell. Secure shell. And what means SH refers to shell and S refers to secure. So using this particular protocol, it will be transmitting the data. What are the packets we are transmitting from, or what are the requests we need to route from client to server, that will be taken care by this particular transport layer. Apart from that, it also has other layers, something called as TSN and console. Using that also it can provide. And there is one more protocol it can use, something called as beep. So these are the protocols that are actually provided by something called as what we call transport layer. So what do you mean by beep here? So beep is nothing but, it's called block extensible exchange protocol. Beep is nothing but block extensible exchange protocol. Okay, so this is what we call it as BEEP. BEEP. Well, it supports this protocol also. It is, these are the protocols used for transmission purpose between the client and the server, or management systems and devices. Okay, sorry. Okay, after that we have something called as RPC or notification. I think you people are familiar with RPC. It is nothing but remote procedure calls. So what is the main purpose of remote procedure calls? We already know that. So it is used for communication purpose. Okay, so between two different devices, in order to provide communication, we use remote procedure calls. Now here what it's saying in this is, this particular RPC uses XML based encoding scheme. It uses XML-based encoding scheme, because since we are talking about network here, the everything, whatever we are talking is an open network. So within the network, there will be intruders who will try to access our information. So in order to protect our information, we need to have something called as protection, right? Some kind of security. So here this RPC uses XML-based encoding scheme in order to encode the data whichever we are transmitting. Apart from that, it will have several different type of operations too, yes. It does have different type of operations. Okay, so some are been provided here. Remaining I'll show you in the next slide in the format of a slide. So here we have something called RPC, RPC reply. This is nothing but for requesting, we use this particular tag. So since I think you people are familiar with XML, how we usually XML like this, right? We have some tags. And finally slash XML. So same like your HTML tags, we have XML tags. So these are the XML tags what we have. Based upon this tag, your system is going to perform operation. Well, we are talking about here network related programming. Those are purely based on XML and HTML type of tags, not exactly HTML. So here we have RPC, RPC reply. Now this particular functions or this particular methods or operations are used for performing request and reply. Like RPC might be used for requesting from client to server to establish a connection. And RPC reply is something like sending a response from server to the client. That is what represented here. Okay, so this is what related to this particular thing. Now the configuration, whereas coming to this particular separation related thing, coming to the third one, that is operation. Well, you can see here also it provides a different type of operations here, like get config. And remember one thing, these are very much clear. These operations, whatever is talking here in operation session or the layer, the different operations are represented in a format of tags, and these tags represent very specific kind of activity. Not all different type of activities it provides. Like for example, get configuration, it will try to get only the configuration bit, since we have two different type of data, configuration data, state. Now if you use this tag, something called get config, it will try to get only the configuration data. It will not try to get the state data. We have one more tag, something called as get. If we use this particular get in the layer, then this will try to get both the configuration data and state data. So that is what I mean to see here. This operation layer consists of different type of tags, operational tags, and they are very much specific to whatever we are specifying in that particular tag. Based on the tag only, it is going to perform different operations. I will show you how that particular things will be present, means how the, what are the different operations we do have. Next, last one is something, we have something called content, and this will consist of this state information and configuration data. So in order to retrieve that, we can use this particular netcom protocol. Okay, it provides, moreover, this network configuration protocol will be providing a clear separation between the configuration data and the state data. So it will never mix this particular protocol, never mixes this state data and the configuration data together. Every time it will provide separately based upon the methods and the functions and the operations what we are using in this particular layer. Okay, and here all these layers, whatever we are talking about, this content and operation, these are YANG defined. Means whatever the code is being used, see this operation tags, what you people are seeing here, these are actually defined by YANG module. Whatever the content, content consists of what? It consists of configuration data as well as state data. So in whenever we want to retrieve it, we'll use this operations and try to retrieve it. So whatever the program we are writing in order to retrieve that particular packets and information, that is purely based on YANG. Okay, I hope it is very clear till here. And the final one, what we have is server. The server will definitely will have a data storage, right? Database. That is basically with respect to our Java programming. But here we have data store. Okay, it is a one kind of database, but we are calling it as data store. What kind of data store it is? Netconf configuration data store. Now this particular data store is used in order to get the information. Whatever the information is required related to configuration, related to state information. So state consists of two types, I told you, right? Operational as well as what we call operational. Another one is statistical. So that data will be provided by this particular Netconf configuration data store. I hope it's very clear till here. Yeah. So let's go to the next part so that we can continue with this. So here he is actually describing whatever I have explained to you people in the previous slide showing the diagram. That is what he is explaining. Just have a look. So first, what he's saying, it works on SSH model. I already told you it's a secure shell transport layer protocol which has been used. And this protocol, and one of, oh yeah, just one more thing which I forward here is, it is an end-to-end connectivity. End-to-end connectivity means between the client and the server, we will be having a connection. And that connection is a purely physical type, okay? Something like that it will be having. And in this, with the help of this connection, it will be providing, sending the packets between the client and server. So what does that mean? It's purely reliable. It is not using UDP. It is something like TCP. So TCP is reliable in nature and it is connection oriented. So that is what it's saying. So it is an end-to-end connectivity and ensures reliable delivery of message. So there will be no loss of messages. And in case there is a loss of a message, that message, that information will be provided to the source so that he can again try to transmit that same message. Now, since I told you coming to the Netconf uses XML encoded remote RPCs. So why this is means? This is for security purpose so that whatever the messages that are being exchanged between the client and server, that should be secured. That's the reason we are using. So whatever the request and response messages we are sending, that will be related to that. Then we have something called as we discussed about configuration state data. So the content layer will consist of configuration state data that I have already explained you. And here, whatever the data is present, that will be based on YANG module. As I told you, whatever the code we are using for operations as well as for methods and to retrieve the configuration state data, we are using a data modeling language called as YANG. Using that only, we people can actually perform the operation. Now, coming to Netconf, it provides, okay, so the remaining thing is same, that whatever we have discussed here. Yeah, so these are the some of the methods what we use. Okay, so here we have something called as connect. So here the description related to that has been provided. Connect is nothing but it connects a Netconf server. If you talk about get here, it retrieves the running configuration and the state information. Get config is nothing but retrieve all or portion of the configuration. Means days, if you observe here clearly, as I told you in the previous slide, get refers configuration state information. But whereas coming to get config, it will try to get only the configuration data. From where? From the data store. It will not try to get other information. Same if you want to edit it, only the configuration data we can edit, but the state data we cannot. Remember one more point, state data can be accessed for reading purpose, but it cannot be changed. For example, DHT sensor is there. It is trying to access some data, something related to your temperature and humidity. Can you change these values? It's highly impossible because this particular what we call device is meant to read the temperature in real time. From the environment, he is trying to read temperature. Let us suppose today we have something like 23 degrees centigrade. If you change this to 50 degrees, is it possible to change? It's highly impossible. Why? Because these are meant only for reading purpose. So whatever the data, operational data is in red, that can be only used for reading purpose. We cannot try to change it. So using the data, we can perform analysis. but we cannot try to modify that particular data. And even if we are modifying, it's of no use. Same way we have copy configure. So whenever, as I told you in the previous session, that we have two devices, one more device is coming. So we need to get the configuration of this particular data, and that should be uploaded to this particular device so that they can start communicating with each other. That is what comes under here, copy configure. Same way we have something called as delete configure. Same. So if you want to remove a configuration from this particular device, that you can do it using this particular. Same way we have lock, unlock, get schema, commit, close session and kill session. So these are some of the methods what we can use, or the operations we can use. Okay. So in which layer we are going to use is nothing but your operational layer. So in the previous diagram, since I have shown you, here, so this layer. In this layer, we are going to use that particular methods, whatever I have shown you right now. So after this, I will be explaining you the process, how this particular, now how the client and server is going to get communicate with each other. Let me show you with the help of a small example. Now here we do have a client here we do have a server. So how this particular client and server communicate now? Using this network management protocol, how these are communicating means, first the client will send a request to the server. So what will happen, the server, so when this connection will be established, okay, the server will respond and there will be a connection established between the client and the server, same like your TCP. Now when this connection is established, they first exchange a hello message. Whenever we make a call to our friends, first thing what we say, hi, how are you? Same thing. Here also these people are exchanging their information, like hi. Like say here we have hello message. Now this message consists of information related to each other's capabilities. Okay. Something like, you know, you people are having an opponent. You're playing a game, you have an opponent. So you people will exchange your information, means views. Like I'm good at something like this, I'm good. Same way here, this client and server will communicate with each other and they will provide their capabilities. Like server will say, I can handle 2 requests at a time. Client is saying, I can request 3 responses at a time. So what will happen? The client will try to send only 2 requests, because if the client tries to send a third request, 3 requests at a time, 1, 2, 3, the third request will not reach the server. Why? The capability of the server, at a time, it can read only 2. So by the time it will read 2, the third request will get lost. Okay, so it will be lost in the network. That is, so based on that. Now we are coming to client, what he's saying, he can handle 3 responses at a time. So the server will try to send 3 responses simultaneously. Why? He is caliber of handling 3 responses simultaneously. But if the server tries to send 1 more at a time along with the remaining 3, this particular response will be lost from the network. Why? The capability, his capability only 3. So that information is exchanged within the hello message. Next, what we have, so here client can send multiple requests. As I told you, since just an example I have given you, but server, you people know that it can handle millions of instructions or transactions at a time. So here the client can send multiple requests to the server. And here this particular protocol will perform management of this client and the server. Whatever the communication takes place, and that communication perfectly done or not will be taken care by this particular NetCon network management protocol. And how it is doing, that we have seen in the previous diagram related to the different layers that have been using this particular protocol. Okay. Yeah. So basic thing what we are going to discuss, related to NetConf is that we are using something called configuration data store. So what do you mean by data store is nothing but it consists of information used for storing the information. What kind of information we are storing is nothing but configuration information. Okay, and it will have something called initial state to the operational state, everything. Means this configuration data store can be used to configure the systems that are deployed. Systems are nothing but IoT devices that are deployed in the network. Whenever a new configuration comes, we need to update that version. Like in our smartphones, we get updated versions, right, of our operating system. What we do, we update it. Same way here also, the updations are done using this configuration data. Since it is a connection-oriented protocol, it is purely reliable. So we don't have to worry about losing any kind of configuration data when we are transmitting from source to the destination. And moreover, transport layer also provides other features, something called as authentication, data integrity, and confidentiality. Obviously, we discussed about security. It uses XML encoded security, right, for transmission of data. So that is concerned authentication. Data integrity is nothing but whatever the data we are transmitting to this device is, that should be compatible with that particular device. Confidentiality should be there. Other devices should not be able to read the data what is sent to the other devices, isn't it? So that is what it's saying related to your NetConf. Now, this is related to your entire thing, related to your NetConf. So apart from that, we have something called as Yang module here. So just hold on. Yeah, Yang. So what do you mean by Yang? As I told you, this is a data modeling language. Use it to model the configuration and the state data. Whatever the NetConf, see both are interchangeable, I'm going to use. Whatever the NetConf protocol is going to use, okay, the configuration state data, that configuration and the state data will be generated, will be performed, will be manipulated using this particular language called as DML, okay, data modeling language. That is nothing but Yang. Now here, this configuration data, state data, and RPC calls, whatever we have seen in the diagram, this all will be taken care by this particular module. This is a module which actually uses. And moreover, it is also responsible for exchanging the data between the client and server. So right from client to server, whatever the layers we do have here, all these layers will be gathering, means these are actually Yang defined. I think if you have seen in the previous slide, these are Yang, means how the configuration data is read, how the configuration data is updated, same with the state data, all that information is provided by this particular Yang module. Indirectly, the background work is done by this particular module. And if this module is not there, NetConf network protocol will not work properly. Now, when we are using this, definitely we are going to arrange, as I stated earlier, we do have something called NetBeans or Eclipse. Whenever you people are creating projects, we have a systematic way of hierarchical structure. How you creating pages, which page is connected to which particular page, and what information, how the message is passing from one particular page to another, that information. Same way here also, Yang module has a structure, hierarchical tree structure, and the bottom will be having something called as leaf nodes. Okay, now these leaf nodes are generally specified either using leaf list constructs or normally as a leaf. Now every node will be organized using a container. Means we will be having a container like this. Within that we will be having the leaf nodes. This is the main part. This is what the main thing what we have. This is like module. This module has sub-module. So this module, whatever we have, we are calling it as a container. I will show you diagrammatically in the coming slide. And this container will consist of sub-module, right? This module consists of sub-module. And these are what we are calling it as leaf. These sub-modules are what we are terminating as, or we are calling it as leaf nodes. Okay, so this is what is related to that, and moreover, it can model the configuration data and the state data based upon the config statement, whatever we have. So what are the methods we have declared there? Based on that, this particular Yang module can perform configuration, that may generate configuration data, as well as it can read the state data, and that data can be analyzed using different protocols or algorithms. Now this is what I am going to show here. So what are the different node types we do have related to your Yang module here? See, don't get confused. You might be getting a question that where this actual thing, where sir is explaining this, but where we are using. I will show you in the next slide, okay, in the diagrammatic way. So you'll get a clear picture, understanding a picture. Just understand the concept here. First, we have something called leaf node. So what do you mean by leaf node? Means it is a simple data structure. Like something like integer and string representation, whatever the data types we use while writing a code. So that is what represented using this leaf nodes. Okay, and it will have only one value. Every leaf will have only one value, and that is, and there will not be any child. Leaf is ultimate. Even in your algorithms or what we call in your tree structures, you might have gone through in your data structures, you might know that whenever we are representing a tree structure, and the bottom will be having leaf. These are what we call it as leaf nodes, right? These are what we call parent nodes, or this is a parent main root node. So see, the last one we are calling it as leaf node. So leaf node will not have any other nodes. If it has another node, then this is not a leaf node. This is a leaf node. So that is what he's saying here. Every leaf node will not have any other child node, and it can have exactly only one value. Next, what we have is leaf list node. It generally represents the list related to that particular node, how many leaves are there in that or not, that will be provided. container node, as I told you, we have a module here. So this is what we call it as a container node. And this container node will consist of different leaf nodes. And then finally, we have something called list node. List node is nothing but it represents the total list. Okay. So every list will have its own key value, and that will be used for specific purpose. That is for representation purpose. That's it. Nothing else. Let me show you so that you can understand clearly. You might be in a confusion state. This is an example. Well, we cannot go in depth in this particular diagram. This is related to SNNP. Okay. Now let me explain it so that you can understand. Now this is what we call it as your, what are the nodes we are talking about. Now this is the module of your YAN. Okay, YAN module. So what do you mean by YAN? This is nothing but a data modeling language. Use it to model all the parameters or writing the program so that the netconf can work properly. The netconf, network configuration, can work properly based upon the layers whatever we are provided. Now if you look at here, the first part, this is what the netconf, this is a representation of a YAN module. So I think you people might have seen this in your NetBeans, isn't it? NetBeans and Eclipse, you people might have seen it like this. When you click on this, you'll get subparts. Again, clicking on that, you'll get subparts. Okay, this is what this representation is what is talking about YAN module. Now here, if you look at it, this is an example of a toaster. Well, this is not a bread toaster, actually. It is similar to that, but it is related to SNMP protocol. So this is a tutorial. In the tutorials of SNMP, you people will be seeing an example related to your toaster. Okay, so this is for network management. Whatever you people are saying, this is not the bread toaster what we have. Like you might be seeing white bread, wheat bread. This is related to bread concepts, but these are used in our network. These are not the physical toasters what we have to burn our bread or toast our breads. Okay, this is related to your network. Within the network, they are using this concept. Like, you know, we do have Android, different type of like Jelly Beans. So Jelly Beans is the Android operating system, but actually Jelly Beans is the candy, isn't it? Same way we have something called donuts. Donut is, it is a eating thing, but we do have Android name. Same way here, he has given these names, but these are not that bread, real bread. So in SN, using SNNP protocol, we might be communicating, we are managing the network. So for that, they have written the program, and in that they have used it, this particular. So they have given the name as toaster. Now in this, the first one, what you are seeing is, this is a header. The first one, what you are seeing is header. Now every thing will have a different icon. You can see this. Please concentrate on this, okay? So you can see that this is a different icon. This is a different icon. This is a different, these two are same. Okay, there are coming to this. These are different. This one, this is a folder representation. This is some kind of icon representation, not known type of symbol. Okay, so if you look at here in this particular, the first one is what we are calling it as a header. This one is what I am calling it as header. And this header actually consists of some kind of identities which are used within the network. So what kind of identities we do have here is nothing but, we have toaster, so it actually represents the toast type. Okay, these are different sections what we have. Okay, so which will be, though, if you look at here header, this has identity declarations here, and these are of different. So what is identity declaration is nothing but, these are the different type of bread related information provided. Based on this particular bread information, whatever is given, the network will be functioning. Based upon, if you use Trojan Waffle, it will be performing some kind of performance in the network. If you use wheat bread, it will perform some kind of performance. Well, we do have a programmatic part also for this. I will provide you in the notes. Here I can't represent that, but we will not be executing anywhere. If you want to execute this, you should have a very good grip on your SNMP protocol, how it works, what are the different IDs used for that, then only we can execute this. Then we have toaster. Now, what is this toaster? This is what we call it as container. Like in the previous slide, I told you. We have container, and this container consists of leaf nodes. So he is representing leaf nodes with the leaf. You can see this. And here toaster is what we call it as a container. Okay. Now this leaf nodes contain only one value. So definitely you can see that there are no more additional things present for that particular thing. Now every leaf node will have a definition which will represent the type of leaf node it is, and it will consist of a description related to that, and as well as the default value. So every leaf node which is represented here will have a default values. Okay. And same way it will have some information why that leaf node we are using it. Now after that we have something else, two different kind of symbols, arrow symbols with the blue color. These are RPC. Like in the layers we discussed about RPC, no? So what kind of RPC we are using? We have two different type of RPCs we are using: make toast, cancel toast. So every RPC will consist of again something called containers as well as leaf nodes. So if you look at your output and input, these are related to transactions, sections. These are sections. And the input section consists of one leaf, another kind of a section. So this is the way it is actually represented. Okay, this is nothing but a hierarchical structure. That's it. How you people are creating the pages in your HTML using NetBeans and all, that will be represented in a hierarchical fashion. Same way, this is also going to be represented. So this is what we have here. So here we do have two RPC definitions, that is cancel toast and make toast, and they are represented with a separate kind of symbol. So this is the way how we can represent the YAML module, since it is a data modeling language. Next topic what we have is, now we are coming to the main concept what we have discussed, IoT system management with NetConf and YAML. Earlier we discussed about why this IoT system management is required, management of this IoT system is required. Then we discussed about NetConf, then YAML, and now we are clubbing it up. So this is a basic generic architecture related to your NetConf YAML used for IoT system management. If you look at here, this is the operator. The first person here you can see as a operator. Now this operator can, now this is related to your network devices. We discussed in the previous slide. You can go through the video so that you can understand what do you mean by network device. Within the network device, we have all these things. And here, this network device can be accessed with the help of something called as management system. Okay? This management system will be communicating with this network device using NetConf. So what are the instructions this operator is going to give? He will be giving using this particular management system. And it will be transmitted to this particular network device using NetConf network management protocol. Okay, so let's see them one by one. So first thing what we have here is something called as management system. Now he is responsible for performing like sending the message between client and server. Okay, between client and server, the previous diagram what we have seen, this management is actually responsible for sending the state information and receiving configuration and state information. Okay, this is the one who is responsible for sending information from here to here, client and server. So what kind of information? State information. So state, I already told you, we have two different type of states: operational state and statistical state. Then configuration state is also being transmitted between these two. Now coming to the management API, this one, we'll discuss one by one. Management API is actually mainly concerned about how to start the session between the client and server, means how the communication takes place between the client and server. How it takes place? The first thing what I said is, first time when the connection is established between the client and server, they will be taking place with the help of a hello message. Now that message, how it is transmitted is using management API. Then we have transaction manager. Now this particular transaction manager is responsible for performing ACID properties. Yes. This transaction management is responsible for performing transactions between client and server. Means nothing but request and response. But it is based upon one some property called as ACID. It has an abbreviation. I will show you in the next slide. ACID. Remember that. ACID property. Next we have rollback manager. What is the rollback manager thing is, when we are configuring the systems which are deployed in the environment, as I told you, they have to be configured simultaneously. Now let us suppose these two devices got configured, but this did not configure. Then what did I say? The previous one, means the next devices which got configured, that has to be moved back to the previous state, means previous version, so that they can communicate. Or else what will happen? These two devices are with new configuration. This is with the older configuration, so they will not be able to communicate properly. So in order to overcome them, so whatever the new version we have updated, we'll roll back that. That rollback management is done by this particular manager. Then we have something called data model. Well, this is also a manager. So name itself is specified. It actually keeps track of all the applications which provide data. Okay, it actually keeps track of all the data which are being exchanged between the client and server. That is going to be managed by this particular data model manager. Next, we have something called configuration validator. So configuration of these particular devices, whatever are deployed. So he is the one who validates whether all the network devices have got configured or not. In case it is not configured, it will send information to the rollback manager and he will roll back the latest versions, whatever been updated in this particular server. Then we have authentication authorization that is related to your security purposes. Then we have configuration database. You know that where it will be present here. In the previous slide, we have seen data store. That data store is what we are calling it as configuration database. Finally, we are having configuration API and data provider API. These application program interfaces are required for communicating with the IoT device. If you see here, this entire thing is a network device. Within that, IoT devices are located here. And this particular process, this particular thing in the network device is meant for communication between this IoT devices and this particular management device. So this is the architecture related to that. Your NetComp Young Network Management. So this is the basic explanation. Whatever I've explained it, I have represented in a systematic way here. This is what you concentrate on here, asset properties. The transaction management performs transaction between the client and server, but it is based on asset property, as I told you. So what do you mean by asset property? Is nothing but each one has an abbreviation. A represents atomicity, C represents consistency, I represents isolation, and D represents durability. So if you talk about atomicity, it is the main purpose of this atomicity is making sure whatever the transaction is taking place between the client and the server using NetComp architecture, protocol, it should be done completely. The transaction should be completely done, or else it should not be completed. Means only 50% completed means that 50% will be rolled back. Okay, it should be 100%. If it is not 100%, then definitely it will roll back. Next comes consistency. What is the main purpose of the responsibility of consistency here is making sure whatever the configuration is there, once whatever the device configuration is there, that should be valid. Like as I told you, two systems are having one configuration, third system is having another. So there is no consistency. So these devices cannot communicate with that. These two devices can communicate, but these two devices cannot communicate with this device. Why? It is running on a different version. These two are running in a different version. To overcome that, we are using consistency. Next is isolation. Now, this also has some responsibility. What is the responsibility it has? Making sure whatever the transaction takes place, the results are present in the same device. Okay, so present in that particular device. That is what comes under isolation. So they should be present in the same device where it is getting executed so that it can be accessed easily. Or else what will happen if the data is lost, we cannot access it. Then we have something called as durability. So the durability is related to, just a minute. Okay, the durability is actually related to commitment, means whatever the commitment, I think you might be having knowledge related to your ATM cards. When you're performing some transaction, commit is a command which is used. Yeah, I think mostly used in databases. Commit in the sense nothing but that transaction is committed perfectly. So for that purpose, we use this durability concept. Ensures that whatever the transaction is committed will persist. Means once that particular transaction is done, that should be there as it is. It should not be again reshuffled or remodeled. For example, if people insert an ATM, you insert an ATM card in an ATM and you retrieve some amount like 2,000, 3,000. So the remaining balance, whatever is shown to you, that should be present there. It's not that it is representing the same amount even though you are detecting the amount. Like for example, out of 5,000, you have detected 2,000. It should show you only 3,000 rupees. It should not show you 5,000 rupees. So that is what comes under durability. Okay, it is very clear. So these are some of the things what we have. And coming to the roles of various components, we already discussed about rollback manager data model. This is what I'm representing here. You people can just go through it. I'll provide you the slides too. Whatever I've explained using the diagram, that is what represented here, nothing else. So you people can go through the slides when I'll provide you. Now, this is NetOpir. So NetOpir is another tool used for your NetConf Young model. Okay, this is one of the tool used. And this is the architecture related to your NetOpir. Remember, this is a tool used. This is a tool. It is a tool used for NetConf Young. Okay, and here it is having its own architecture. You can see a management system like your Netconf architecture. So here we have SSH server. So we have a server here. SSH server is nothing but in order to provide communication between the client and the server, we are using this SSH server. Here we have NetOpeer agent. This agent will try to communicate, provide communication between this management system and this server. And same way here, this server consists of YANG and Trans API modules, and these will be provided. Means who is actually providing that? Means we have something called NetOpeer manager. We have here NetOpeer manager. Now this manager will make sure that these modules are performing or executing perfectly in the server. The communication, whatever is required, this network manager will provide the information to the server so that it can work properly. Okay, and we also have a configuration data store for updating or configuring the data, and that data will be configured in where server. So there is a communication from server to configuration, and whatever the information is there which the client want to send to the IoT device, that will be communicated using SSH server, the network NetOpeer agent to NetOpeer server. Now this server will provide the communication to the IoT device. So whenever you want to update the configuration, you want to update the configuration, or you wanted to update the data, that information your people will be transmitting with the help of a server to the IoT device. But how that is getting transmitted from your smartphone? Let us suppose you are using a smartphone. Using that, you are sending the information to the device. So this is the internal structure, how it exactly works. Okay, basically we do have some steps related to NetOpeer. We will not be discussing that here. In the coming unit, you have a case study. There we will be using this particular NetConf YANG model, and with the help of that, we'll be performing the operation. So if we have around 7 steps, like establishing a connection, and then like in computer networks, we discuss whenever the client and server wants to communicate with each other, we have some steps. What is that? Establishing a connection between the client and server. Now the client will send a response. For that, the server will send a acknowledgement. Again, the client will be sending some request. The server will send a response. Finally, the connection has to be terminated. Same way, whatever we discussed in this particular diagram slide, this will be represented in the format of a step, one after another. And using this step, we will be performing the operation. That we will discuss in the coming units when we will discuss this particular protocol using a device. Remember only one thing, NetOpeer is actually related to a tool used in your NetConf, okay? So don't get confused that this is a separate kind of protocol. This is related to your NetConf YANG. It is a tool used for establishing a connection. And the architecture is this. So here, within this, we also have, as I told you, we have different agents. We have NetOpeer server, agent, client. So whatever I have shown you in the previous diagram, so that is what he's talking about here, NetOpeer agent. Why? What is the responsibility of agent? Transmitting whatever the information or the commands that have been received from the client to the server. NetOpeer server responsibility is managing the IoT devices. What about client here? What are the configuration data we need to give? That will be provided here. So configuration update and the state information, that is operational data, statistical data, that will be taken care by this particular NetConf configuration. Manager, I told you, what is the main purpose of manager? Configuration and operational data. So we have seen something like YANG here, TLSI, that is connected to the server. So this network manager is going to take care of that particular thing. I'll show you one more time so that it becomes easy for you to understand. So network manager here, the network manager. So here we have a network manager. So this communication, YANG module and Transact API module, will be communicated to this particular server using this network manager. That is what he means to say in this particular video. So basically, this is actually related to your computer network related programming. We cannot show it here. It requires different kind of modules. We cannot use NetBeans to execute them. We require some separate kind of ID. Based on that, we can execute it. But since we don't have that, only the basic information we are sharing with you related to this, okay? So finally, that's all about for today's session. We actually complete your second unit. Thank you for watching.